Hello, I'm Andy Nastally, Performance Manager with Dealertrack DMS, and I want to talk to you today about form sequencing and assignment. Now, if you're like me and you're in the deal screen and you want to print a form, you have all these different forms in here. You have to go through and select which one and kind of find them in the list. It gets annoying. So I like to set them up a little bit more logically. You do that by going up to More and going to Doc Generation and then Form Sequence. You'll see your list of forms within the menu there. Now, you can go through here and select these. I like to do it by 10 so that if we need to add a form at a later date, we can always do that. Now, you'll notice that this is 10, 15, 20, 30, 40. So that means this form was added or moved at a later time from when this was first set up. Now, if this form is a new form, I need to throw that in there between 15 and 20. I can just name that 16. It gives me a little bit more freedom on where I want to put these forms. Once your form sequence is set up the way you like it, we'll go over and assign those to the specific deal. One thing to keep in mind, if you have a group of forms, you know, 5 or 10 forms that are going to be in every single car deal, let's go ahead and put those right at the very top. Makes it nice and easy when you're in the print form screen to just select those top forms that are going to be in every car deal. Once you have your sequence done, like I said, we'll go to assignment. You do that through setup forms. If you select that, you'll see all your forms listed in here as well. On the far right, it indicates whether it's an impact or a laser form with the I or the L. And we're going to select this first one as an example and assign that by selecting 8. Now, if we only want this to be required on new and used, we'll select always required, new and used, or we could select some of the options below. Once that's done, we'll select trade, because we only want this to show up when there's a trade. Now, if this isn't there, you do 1 to assign, hit enter. And now this form will only show up when there is a new or used car and a trade. If we didn't want the trade option, we could go in there and do 4 to remove it. And that's going to show up on every car deal is new or used car deal. Now, another one that I like to do is say, for instance, bank contracts. No sense in seeing all the different contracts in there if that bank uses a specific one, in this case, a lease. If we want to assign that to only show up when it's a lease deal for Chase, we can go ahead and do 8 to assign, hit enter, and then we're going to select lease sources. From here, we'll go ahead and select Chase Auto Finance for assign and hit enter. So now that's only going to come up when Chase is selected in the lease. Another option that a lot of people like to do if they have an out-of-state deal and there's a few forms required for specific areas, we can base that on tax groups so that those forms only show up on out-of-state deals. No sense in clogging up this list with a bunch of forms that you don't need. With that being said, we're all done. Let's go ahead and conclude. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to your performance manager and you have a wonderful day.